again.
Who do you think will be the first to ask us questions? Mateo or Noel?
Constellation has suffered losses before, although none quite so
violently. Don't mind
violently.
Me. Tip your ear later. Home's got a sanctity. Hard to fix once it's broken. Been poring over the charts, looking for another match. Think this one might just be it.
Understood.
Whew. Always a satisfying moment to return to your ship.
Hey.
Oh, pardon me. Was that your stomach or mine?
Insertion done. Time to dance among the stars.
Thank you.
indigenous life signs. One less thing to worry about, I suppose.
Constellation has been for. This place, the Starborn, all of it. Thank you.
I do not spend as much time here as some of the others, but I appreciate that I was still given my own room.
Morale in the lodge has been measurably reduced.
Waiting for time's passage is the only cure for Constellation's wounds. Found one. Easy as a needle in this stack. Hope those powers you're getting to overinflate you. Got enough egos in Constellation.
There are a few injuries that can't be addressed here. If you walk in, you will almost assuredly walk out. Welcome to Reliant. If you're in need of medical assistance or require supplies, I am sure we can accommodate you.
Well, you've certainly come to the right place.
Take care of yourself.
Any adventure you can fly away from. Is that how the saying goes?
Ship's good. Buckle up and let's go.
Foxtrot's primed. Retro's firing.
Even without life, there is the potential for beauty.
To explore.
Hey, 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 all the facts.
I find the interior of this ship comforting.
Situation in the settled systems, we think now is a great time to renew your ship's warranty protection plan, or purchase a new one if you lack coverage. Damaging property of the owning group or its subsidiaries will result in a void of the warranty and an inability to purchase plans in the future. This may impact your ability to live a fruitful and carefree life.
Look alive!
Perhaps not the sort of place on which one would settle down.
I'd like to have seen the construction of this place. The tools, the methods. There's so much that could be learned. imagine how long this has been here. Good to be back in our own ship.
Quite enjoy New Atlantis.
I would like a chance to talk to you, if you are able.
Holmes, don't mind me. Tip your ear later. Got one. I'd go into the astronomical charting data with you, but clear as day just to point you right to it.
site is sufficient. Take the ship down.
I think I...
I have things I wish to discuss with you. When you have... Can we speak for a moment?
Morale in the lodge has been measurably reduced.
Holmes got a sanctity. Hard to fix once it's broken.
Constellation is no stranger to loss. Our own founder left on an expedition and never returned. It is easy to talk about the glory and excitement of breaching into the unknown, of lighting the darkness. But it is harder to stare into the face of the cost. That all of our progress is built on top of the lives of those who dared. And that we owe them the courage to continue our work. In their memory.
Boy. I've lost my boy. Should be me buried in the ground. All I ever wanted to do was protect him. No. He was out the door as soon as he could. Away from his mother, away from Akilah.
Instead,
away from me.
I thought I would quote something that gave me comfort a long time ago. Is God real? The more proper question would be, is reality divine? Existence itself is a mystery which yearns to be uncovered. What is goodness but a comparison to the good? What is existence but a participation in being? For where the diversity of the universe inspires awe and wonder, it exists only in contrast to a simplicity so pure that it may only be understood as primordial and even divine. Our essence is what was imagined by its mind, but what we consider imagining and what we consider mind are in fact so far beyond our understanding that even these metaphors are like the tiny white caps on a massive searching sea. There's more, but those are the parts that speak to me the most. Thank you.
That was really thoughtful, Mateo. Thank you. Does anyone else want to say anything?
I don't often speak about what I believe in. It seems so redundant with how I live. But death is one of those occasions where it's hard not to look inward. Our friend is gone. There's no afterlife or second meetings. No God in heaven that is curating a perfect ending for them. So it's up to us. We are what lives on. If the pain of loss inspires us to greater action, then that is the good that comes from all this. Humanity is what truly creates our world. We are the ones that judge things to be good or evil, joyful or mournful. Let us take responsibility for it. Let us remember what we have lost.
Walter, are you part of the House of Enlightenment? I never knew that.
Yes, well, I like to keep some things private.
You all might not like thinking about this, but when we die, everything about us breaks down, decomposes, gets eaten up by insects and microbes. Or due to the lack of a biosphere, we are simply carried away by space and time until we sizzle in a distant sun's corona or get pulled in some gravitational field and coalesce with other debris. Not comforting, huh? But I disagree. Do you know what I find uncomfortable? The thought that after I die, the universe is just going to stand still forever. Could you imagine? The fact is that the universe goes on, that life goes on, that things do not just sit still. That right there is the comfort that I need. Yeah, we die. And some people go way before they should. But the universe doesn't care. Not because it's evil, but because it's infinite, ever-expanding. And who wouldn't want to be a part of infinity, even if it's just for a short while? Listen, we don't worry about ourselves before we were born, do we? Of course not. We emerge from the universe as we return to it. And for one beautiful moment, we are here, together.
Yes, that certainly was an interesting perspective, Barrett.